Hi, I'm Willie. Welcome to my channel. Thank you for being here. If this is your first time here, please go down and click subscribe. If you're a return viewer or subscriber, thank you very much. I do appreciate each and every one of you. If you need IT consulting, go to williehow.com, fill out that contact form, and someone will be in touch with you as soon as possible. What we're going to talk about tonight is upgrading your cloud key. So I had a customer in Chicago get a hold of me. And through a series of unfortunate events, the MSP that managed their cloud key with multiple sites on it was no longer in the picture, no longer has passwords, any of that stuff. Their cloud key happened to have an SD card in it. So I have just a Gen 2 cloud key that I hadn't upgraded yet, at least the base OS. And I said, go ahead and send it to me. So they sent it to me. Unfortunately, I'm not able to recover anything. So unless I can find somebody who worked for this company, they are going to be factory defaulting devices and joining to a new controller, you know, somewhere else. However, I logged into my cloud key and it is time to do this. So let's hop over to the cloud key. All right. So here is my Unify Cloud Key G2. Now, Unify itself is on the 6. whatever release. However, you can see based on this that the operating system of the cloud key itself is old. So let's log in. And system stats, firmware. 0.7.7. Now I've got Unify stopped because I was trying to recover, you know, data off of that SD card. Turns out there was no data, so lost cause there. But this thing is several revisions behind. So let's go to configure. It's set for DHCP. So you can see that this is on 0.7.7 and it wants me to upgrade to 2.0.27. So we are way behind. Now, nothing on this cloud key, if it gets wrecked, there's nothing that it's going to take with it. You can see down here that I have SDN updated to 6.0.45 dash blah, 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 whatever the minor release is there. And I did that just messing around. So this is the last time we're going to see this portal on this cloud key is what I think. And so what we're going to do is I'm going to click the update to 2.0.27 button and we're going to see what happens. So do you want to update? Yes, we do. It's going to download. It's going to verify. It's going to install and then it's going to reboot. It's downloading pretty quickly. We're already at like 34%. And I will tell you the download is going much faster than what I thought. Now, this is pretty much a pristine cloud key because every time I would use it, I would factory default it. I tend to take pretty good care of the lab gear. The SD card that you saw in there, that is the SD card that they sent, and there's no files that are recoverable. So it puts them in kind of a bad spot. So what we see here is that the device is rebooting. Your device is rebooting. Please wait until the login page appears. So our old login page was literally just a username and password. It was UBNT and then our super secret lab password. I have no idea what to expect here. So we're upgrading this together. I've had so many bad experiences that I didn't upgrade these yet. I've had people, you know, that we've had to repair their cloud keys. We've had to repair their controllers. We've had to repair their networks just from some of the firmware issues. So I'm not sure it's going to take it too long to boot. Now, also, you'll notice that it is not on this desk. It is in another room plugged into a PoE switch. So, okay. So we are booted. And I was never prompted for any of my cloud credentials or any of those things. Now, remember, this was previously set up. So that setup may come into play if you don't have an existing configuration. So if it's new or maybe out of the box, I don't know. We're going to log in. This is the first time I've done it like this. in the lab. So let's log in with that old credential that we had and see what happens. And I've just got Unified Cloud Key G2. You can see that we've got network on here. So let's take a look at our users. And I've got admin and I've got UBNT. So that's interesting. So let's pull up our local settings portal. And you can see that the owner is UBNT. Let's check for updates. It says it already did. We're still on DHCP. No updates available. Applications, network. We've got location. We got advanced. So remote access is not turned on. Now what I wonder is if when we set up the network, if it's going to make us do that. So I'm going to click check for update on network just to see where we're at. We shouldn't have an update, but I just want to make sure. Okay, so it doesn't seem like there's any update there. So let's launch network and see what happens. And like I said, this already had a default config on it and I just upgraded it. So this did not force us into the cloud configuration or linking this to the cloud. It did enable the new settings. So we'll go to classic settings, lab network, all the things are here. And it did not force that. I wonder if we factory default this, if that's when it's gonna make us set that up. We can definitely try that and see if that's when it is gonna force us to do the cloud stuff, right? So let's do a factory reset. We're gonna confirm. It's gonna tell us that our device is gonna reset and we're just gonna watch the countdown. I have a feeling that this maybe things have changed, right? Since a few weeks ago, a month ago or whatever, when a lot of the bad experiences were happening. So we'll see. It very well could be now that this is going to be kind of fresh with that latest firmware, that's when it's going to, cause us to have to link it to my UI accounts. But we'll see what happens here. All right, so it is rebooted. We got our, it must regenerate the certificate because we got a new error. All right, so now this looks a little different. So we're going to call this U-lab. We're going to agree to the terms and conditions. And here it is. So if you had an account, a pre-existing local account, and things were set up, it does not force you to do this. This is on new setup. So let's walk through this real quick. That's not right. And I gotta have my 2FA code here. All right, update schedule. We're gonna disable that. I don't want it auto updating. We're gonna disable the auto optimize because we see some problems with that as well. And looks like this is good. So we'll finish this. And we'll see what this looks like when we're done setting it up. All right, so it didn't change the settings or the version of Unify. So that is the 6.0.45 is the latest then for the cloud key that's in the the general release. So we'll log into that. Now, even though I'm bound to the UI account, you can see that we're still accessing this locally. But this is why people are upset, because you apparently have to have an internet connection and have to have this bound to a UI account to be able to proceed past this setup. As we saw before, if you already had this, if you had a cloud key and it was already configured locally, then they weren't forcing this. So, or at least they didn't force it here. So it's very, very interesting. What are your thoughts on this? You know, we'll go through a full updated Unify video, but what do you think about this? This process, you just saw it. You saw a pre-existing installation that didn't require us to link it when we did the upgrade, but then you saw after a factory default, we did have to tie it to the UI account. The one thing that I do like about the UI account is that you can then enforce two-factor authentication. Should you have to be tied to the cloud to do two-factor? No, you shouldn't, but this is the way they're handling it. And I'm sure they've got, you know, their business reasons, but what do you think about this? We just saw it work both ways. So let me know in the comments and we'll kind of go from there. So if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. Please subscribe. Please comment, share. Please follow me on Twitter and Instagram. And I think I've got a TikTok link down there too, trying to spin that up. If you need IT consulting, go to williehow.com, fill out the contact form, and someone will be in touch with you as soon as possible. If you'd like to support the channel by using all of our affiliate links, they are down below. They don't change your price, but they do kick a couple bucks over the channel. Once again, I'm Willie. I want to thank you for being here. And as always, I'll see you in the next video.